Rochester's Virginia, not New England. This is a Virginia, our contract's no good. We can do anything we want now.
A little prayer would hurt you, Miles, David.
You'd have us on our knees praying from noon till midnight if you could.
Now. So I'm all up by 6 a.m.
We got better from what we got to get our own stuff back to England.
Pilgrims will have to find some unclean to gain their own food.
To England! Full of trees! You know how much Carol's jaw on can make out of all those trees? Look at that ocean, full of fish. Do you know how much fish those girls can hold? There'll be no stopping us.
Will his girls hold a tiger?
Absolutely. To screw it, I'll ship one King James.
And who would get the blame
when it ate up the king? Not you or any of the other strangers. We would. You can joke about it all you want, Miles Standish. You haven't been thrown in jail for your beliefs. You haven't been hanged.
Not fair, if I've been hanged, how could I be here right now? Enough, you two. We have serious things to discuss.
Messengers have run back and forth between pilgrims and strangers all morning and afternoon. At least it's agreed that some sort of document should be drawn up spell out how they should rule themselves. The pilgrims want to guarantee their own religious freedom. The strangers want to guarantee their own religious beliefs, not the pilgrims. A set of rules and laws upon the agreed to and written down. Isaac Allerton was the last Separatist man to sign this document and his way to our country.
Miles, I'd love to have his name signed by mine. England's an ocean away. I guess we're stuck with each other.
Miles Standish signs the compact one by one to remain in the rest of the strangers from the riches to the poorest, their male servants, and the hard men add their lips to the paper. At this time, the English women are not separate legal voice. None of the English women's names appear on the Mayflower compact. In the first order of business, the men elect John Carver to be the colony's governor.
I have 223 sticks, so you need
Pilgrims Project discussed many things.
We believe in peace, the world of food, but we welcome others like you before. You kidnap us, you bring secrets to us. Look at what you've done to Squanto. Look at what you've done to this village.
We come here in peace to live here in peace. We know that it's left to be hunted and to lose our home, but he says it's true.
So we must help each other. You gave me the tools.
Agree. Well, not take to each other or fight each other.
resourceful drama instructor, so I'd like to give Ms. Merrill a hand.
Thank you.
after several delays, the Mayflower set out of Plymouth, England. 66 days later, they were spotted, although they had landed off the shore of Cape Cod rather than Virginia. The settlers tried to remain in New England. They anchored in Provincetown Harbor, but found that the land there could not support them. Before going ashore, the Pilgrims and Strangers forged these ever rules that would govern them. This document, known as the Mayflower Compact, set down the principles of self-rule. In December, they settled in what is now Plymouth, Massachusetts.
For the first time in 66 days, the passengers of the Mayflower allowed a fun. About half of the people are separatists or pilgrims, about 10 to this point of religious freedom. The other half, about 50 people, are strangers, servants, and migrants. The strangers have been living in the to a better economic life. Everyone decides to be able to travel through.
Hey, God, but that means we're off the coast of New England. Ah, just look at it, Mary. It's when all the slaves.
I see a tiger. Look, on the beach.
Where? I don't see anything.
It's gone now. Mary's right. Prosperous land in Virginia, not New England. Our contract says Virginia. If this isn't Virginia, our contract's no good. We can do anything we want now.
A little prayer would hurt you, Miles Standish.
You'd have some knees for noon till midnight if you could.
Now, go on all our friends to England, and we got better guns, blood, get our own dog back to England.
Down here, we have to find our blood to get their own food.
New England, full of trees. You know how much girls' dog you can make out of those trees? Look at that ocean full of fish. Do you know how much fish those barrels can hold? There'll be no stopping us.
Wait, his barrels hold a tiger?
Absolutely. Just to prove it, I'll ship one to King James.
And who would get the blame when it ended up the king? Not you or any of the other strangers. We would. You can joke about it all you want, Miles Standish. You haven't been thrown in jail for your beliefs. You haven't been hanged.
Now, Mary, if I had been hanged, how would I be here right now?
Enough, you two. We have serious things to discuss.
Messengers have run back and forth between Pilgrims and Strangers all morning and afternoon. At least it's agreed that some sort of document should be drawn up about how they should rule themselves. The Pilgrims want to guarantee their religious freedom. The Strangers want to guarantee their religious freedom. Exploring parties go out to search for a good site to build a town. Some find sea corn buried in baskets and take the corn back to Mayflower. In late December of 1620, a party finds site with a stream near. In abandoned fields of corn, the site was once a Patuxent Indian village. Pilgrims and Strangers agreed to build their town here at Plymouth. That first winter's hard, many people die of illness, probably either tuberculosis or pneumonia. But the building goes on. A common house was raised first. After that, about five or six rough houses are finished. March 16, 1621, the word surrounding the town of Plymouth. Mary and Remember Allerton are collecting sticks of firewood. They don't see Samus Head, who was watching from behind the tree and enjoying the camps.
Okay. only 999 more sticks. Try counting your pile again, little brother. Which one tells sticks to me?
You're an Indian!
Oh, do I have to give the stick back to him?
Hey, wait a minute! Wait just a minute! I can understand him! He ain't an Indian! He speaks English!
You can speak your mind language if you want to. Do you speak any Abenaki?
No, I know some Dutch.
You got me there. My friend's Ponca does this. He's meant to England and States. Might be different from the Dutch along the way.
Is Squanto an Indian?
He's up in Texas. These are the birds that are the same part of the cornfields.
Are they going to want everything back?
You're all dead. Some people. Ponca's the only for Texas left. Maybe it's
like fish? No, the corn tastes more like corn, you'll see.
Well, I'm going to have to bend. Sorry about that. We have some flowers. This one goes to Ms. Marta Merrill, if you can go right up those steps and hand those to her, for helping us, because we couldn't have done it without her. She's such a wonderful addition to our team. And this bunch is for Ms. O, because without her, we wouldn't have the video and the sound system up tonight, so we'll truck those up tonight. And this set is for Ms. Stevenson. You'll make your way down the steps. This set is for Ms. Stevenson, because we couldn't have our music without her. This set is for Ms. Going, because she has helped so much with the artwork and things like that with our community. Our community is on display at the board, and she has been so instrumental. And you and your kids did a wonderful job on the models. I know we have some future architects, but she has displayed them in such a way to show all the wonderful details. And I just wanted to thank those teachers. You'll take these to Ms. Gower. And then this set of flowers is for one of our parents who worked so diligently into the night on our costumes that you see. And that would be Ms. Sanders, Molly's mom. So I'm going to let Molly get these to her mother. Costume pieces that you see, and that would be Sydney's mom. So if you give all of these adults a round of applause, we wouldn't have done it without them. Tonight, at the Board of Education, the community is on display. The children have worked hard with you, and they sent out the flat Stanleys to the community. Some of the children have volunteered to read the letters to the Board of Education tonight. We are on the schedule tonight, like in the next 15 minutes. And the thing is televised. And I would really appreciate it if you would support us just a few minutes longer and make your way up to the Board of Education and bring your child so that we can show off what Garfield Academy students are capable of doing. And thank you so much for being here tonight.